chanced upon somebody who asked me, you know, when you meet someone and they just want to know what you're all about, say actually it was Bina baby. And I was like, what do you mean in Ninamikwano Jag? It's like, Panange, you diss everyone. I'm like, correction, I don't diss. I check you into position. She's like, anywho, you know, like some of us, celebrities walk up to us, they talk to us as like, let me try and think. No, Winnie Nwaji bumped into me. I bumped into Winnie Nwaji last Friday and she was all looking at me. She could undress me, beat me up with just the look on her face. She was like, do I care? No, not really. Here's the thing. We don't care much for you liking us, but we care much for you knowing that we know what you do. You get what I'm saying? So about friends, nah. I don't think I need me that many. My name is Tina and welcome to Scoop and Scoop. It's, I don't know the day. I don't want to know the day. Let's just get what's happening in Celebrityville. So I think today is going to be one of those days where I'm going to follow up with Lugambo. Remember how I told you yesterday that Palazzo and MC Katz have a situation going on? I don't know. MC Katz is trying to manage Palazzo, something like that. It's official. According to me, this is official. A while back, Palazzo beat up Ray Signature. Now, you have to think about it. MC Katz was supposedly beaten or driven over or whatever it is that they did to him by someone. And now that Palazzo has moved into his situation, never turned his omuku. But now Palazzo apparently bumped into Ray Signature. He was with his goons. They beat him up, vandalized his car. And what did Ray Signature do? He ran to police as a good citizen who minds what happens to them. He went to police and he reported the case and he's all over social media saying, yes, namuwa abideyo. But I'm like, I don't condone violence, but really, seriously, MC Katz was beaten by someone. He kept quiet. You have joined MC Katz, they have beaten you, you have run to police. What happened to the good old gangster days? You should meet up with Palazzo, meet him halfway. Let's go gangster on this thing. I'm not saying violence is the solution, but you see, Palazzo is lost in this trance. He's in a mantra of sorts. He believes this is still America. So Ray Signature, other than running and crying, mommy, 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 just like your new boy, MC Katz did, meet Palazzo halfway. Palazzo yetaga yo munta na mukuba. Kumanze nkoye. Nkoye okuli rambo Palazzo akubia gundi, akubia. This guy has beaten people. Never ata sobola akuba akubia. Someone needs to do something. Put this boy, typical TIA style. Remember when you thought you were the biggest thing that happened in school? Mbuguoli mukubi. Wagwanga kuba na angaba satu. Neva kugunda, neva kukuba chiza deno kalida. Now that's what Palazzo needs. But as for your Ray Signature, I guess MC Katz is rubbing off you. He's really, really rubbing off you and into you. Not in a good kind of way. Kati gogenda kwete gekira a whole journey of beatings and very bad written spoken English on social media pages. But hey, he was beaten. Still with MC Katz, I can't believe this guy is making my day today in not such a good way. Now, do you guys remember the time when Fia and MC Katz decided to fundraise? We're gonna get married, the wedding should happen real soon. Everybody was up in arms. Some of us really didn't mind. Other people really gave in their money. And it so happens that the money real came through. Now, here's the situation. After Katz dumps, I am saying this with a lot, this is a lot of loose tongue. After MC Katz has dumped Fear, it's apparent that MC Katz has bought himself a plot of land and he is planning on building. That is the moment I was like, Wanji? It so happens, according to a source on the inside, weba tu sabaziri eza guawe za wedding. Bagenda ne bagula kenyu, no, ba renting a kenyu, ba ne bagulida kofi ya motoka. Kati balance ayaba dasiga deo. Katz has bought himself a plot of land, he's planning on building, which I should say is a good thing for him. But now, I am asking myself, Katz, so you left the money maker who would probably give you money. You got this new loose chick. I'm sorry, I don't know the chick, but according to me, any person who wants to, you know, shack up with MC Katz at this particular time in his not so existent career, I would definitely call you loose chick. Yeah, loose chick. So you move in with this chick and you're getting a new house, you're planning on building, you bought a plot of land. Naya money maker, yo!
Fear is on the move. She's going on Cat Uganda College. Because last time I checked, MC Cat's to come at your event and probably MC for the rest of the hours. Now, I'm saying 24 hours because that's how cheap this guy is. You're going to pay him like around 100K. Kakati wona sondela emitwalo kumi, 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 kumi every 3 months or zimbe nyumba di. I'm suggesting, and it's just a humble request, you and Fie, Auntie Mwagala nyo paparazzi, you like this thing. You go tell Fie, honey boo pie pie, let's get back together. Flash it and flaunt it on social media. Tell us, banaita tuagaliza, and we didn't want to see you together. Tell us whatever it is that you want to tell us. Get back together. Then tell people the concert is back on. Do you know how much money that is going to make all of you? You will actually manage to buy an already built house, and Fia could probably get that low-class, cheap-budget wedding that she wanted. I'm just suggesting, but... Yeah, I'm coming from a place of love, but why am I even suggesting? It's what exactly these goons are going to do. You give it their saber. Cats and Fia are going to be walking around like daisies in a field, and they won't even care for nothing. They'll be like, yeah, you know, these things happen, so... Ah, poor loose chick. Over what's her name? I hear you're dating a DJ. You are dating a DJ when Cats took you. Kakati Cats DJ na yagenda kuku baba kubile mchidula DJ chali mchichina. Unokaya fache. Now that's what happens when you are a boy in a man's body. Let's move on. It's been a minute without me talking about Fabiola because I notice there's nothing much that comes to mind when you talk about Fabiola. It's just she is light-skinned, she overdresses up, compensates for all that she lacks as a human being by how she looks. It's been a while, so she took to social media as every socialite in Kampala, I can't call them career-guiding people. She took to social media very, very butt naked, and she caused an uproar. Ah, yeah, yeah, yeah. All the men were crazy. And I saw the photos in the dailies. I was like, okay. Chick went ahead and took her clothes off again. Okay, what's happening? The caption, I don't even want to get into that. So everybody was telling me, did you see Anita's photos? I'm like, no, wait what she piace. Anita has undressed in front of us. Anita has taken very scandalous photos before. What's the big deal about this one? It's like you see her light skin body once, it's going to stay the same. It's not like she's going to have a new mole or a third boob. No, she won't. But then I had to think back and I'm like, wait a minute. Why is Anita trying so hard to overcompensate? Because whenever Anita Fabiola is trying to move on to another level in her life, she drops the naked bomb on us and then it hit me yesterday. Ah, Second Chances, Ugandan version premiered. Banange, I have never wanted to throw up that much in my life. I literally sat with a bucket because I was gagging. Who in the world told these guys they can pull this off? First of all, everybody in this piece is so hilariously boring. They can cause a mind block if you actually sit down and watch them. I was watching this thing and I was like, why? And then people were like, Pop just put us a picture. She just gave us a picture on social media. That's what she was trying to sell. Come on, you Ugandans, Namwe. Hey, so the episode aired yesterday. There is a lot of naked hair everywhere, but it goes to beg the question. Did you ever think about the fact that maybe, just maybe, people like Anita Fabiola are what? They are the true definition of your mindset is in the wrong place. Because think about it, if fashion is one of those things that tells the world how you're feeling at a particular moment, what your mood is, what your mindset is. That is what I believe fashion does to everybody. It helps express the inner things that we can't really put out there. That means in Anita's mind, she's always blank, hence nude. There's nothing much going on there, but I can't call her bimbo anymore because she's been out bimboed. She keeps on out bimboing herself. Now to tumble it out. She's butt naked again. She's trying to promote her new TV show, which is horrible. Let's just wait and see what happens. Then again, I kind of thought about it. Ugandans, you're something else. Let me give you a... Here's how I know that these guys are just going to mess it up and then Ugandans are going to be all over the place. Yay, we're going to watch it. You know why you're going to watch it? Because it's absolute garbage. Now, there's a way we like garbage. When we try to get so serious, just a chitu kolera, mwokwata shonga nunji nyo, erimuru zoom, it is the real deal. Ugandans will be like, I need to beat a baby. But tell them garbage. Ah, Anita Fabiola is going to be undressing. They will watch. Ella is going to force her accent even harder. They will watch. Kwegamba,
I don't even know what to say anymore. You just don't have class anymore. But besides that, my name is Tina. It's been a beautiful day. Don't forget, @TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle. And for all of you on social media, yes, I see you on Facebook. I am trying so hard to reply and respond to all your questions, your messages. For all my YouTube freaks out there, what's up, what's good, what's happening? Did I say hi to everybody? I guess I did. I'm out.